everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make your own planner. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe for more videos just like this one. And without further ado, let's get into the video. So the first thing I'm going to show you guys how to make is obviously the planner itself. So to make my planner, I used a binder, and the one I'm using here is a little bit tinier than the regular binders. I think it's like A5 size. Then I took some marble contact paper and I just started to cover the whole entire binder in the marble contact paper because I thought it would look a bit prettier than just plain old blue. So I first covered the outside with one layer, and then I cut some slits into the corners, and then I folded in the excess contact paper into the inside to give it a nice edge. So after that, your binder should look a little something like this. To cover more blue in the inside, I used some sticker paper and I just peeled off the backing and then stuck that onto the inside. Now I'm going to show you guys how to make some page inserts. So I made mine inspired by the Erin Condren planner, but you can of course make whatever pages you want. So I started off with making a box in a Word document, and I sized it to be 3.8 centimeters times 4.8 centimeters. And then I just removed the shadow, filled it in white, and added a black line around it. Then I repeated the same thing to make a header. This one is 0.6 centimeters times 3.8 centimeters. I wrote the sizes right here on the screen in case you want to use the same, and if you're using inches, you can find them online. A quick disclaimer is that I made my header a light blue color. You can of course do whatever color you want, but don't go too dark because otherwise if you put stickers over it, you might be able to see the color underneath. Then I just grouped the header and the box and copied it 3 times and put those boxes underneath each other. Then I grouped those 3 boxes again and copied the whole entire row and just added 4 of them next to each other. I ended up using 3. I also wrote like the name of the day on the top, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and stuff. And I also added some lines at the bottom for notes. And then I just printed those out. Also, don't forget to leave some space at the side so you can hole punch it later. And then I just cut it out with some regular scissors. Now, I also made a like cover piece. I just took a photo of like a tropical background I found online and just added my name and stuff and printed it out and put it into my planner. Now I'm going to show you how I plan. So you can take out these pages out of your binder, which I think is really great because that way you have a nice sturdy surface and you don't have to like work weirdly over the metal ring thing. I used these stickers that I made myself. I printed them out on sticker paper and then I just stuck them onto my planner. So I always start off with the to-do list on the top, and I added those little headers. Then I add the today row and the little things. Then all the way on the top, I added these heart checklist box thingies. I really love using those because I always make checklists like every day. And then I added some like decorative picture thingies for the today box. I like doing that just as decoration. And then for the bottom part, I just add like a few like little sticky notes and stuff if there is something happening that day. Then I just start to write my to-do list. I wrote down what I have to film and edit and upload and stuff like that. Studying is definitely something I have to do a lot. Once you're done adding in these stickers onto your pages and you're happy with them, you can put them back into the binder just by opening the clip and then putting them back in. Next, I'm going to show you guys some planner supplies. So the first thing here, I made these myself. They're little tiny bows I made from perler beads, and I just glued them with some hot glue onto a paper clip, and I'm popping one right in here so that I can use it sort of as like a bookmark type thing. You can of course also use sticky notes and washi tape to decorate however you would like. You kind of have to figure out a way of how you like to plan and then just go with it. Try to test out a bunch of different things and then just go with what works best for you and have fun with it. So also in the front here, I used some sticky notes and just added it on there, and then I just wrote down a few important things that I'm not allowed to forget. So that was it for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. I love you all so much, and I will talk to you again next year. Happy New Year! Bye!